Filmmakers and creatives, welcome to Share Stitchery. I'm Katherine Harris, and I have very exciting news. I am releasing another new pattern, and it is called the Ava Circle Skirt, and it is a great versatile staple to have in your wardrobe. And it goes from 18-inch doll sizes, that's the American Girl dolls, through to infants, so 3 months old through to 24 months old, a kid's size from ages 2 through to 12, and then we have our regular Missy sizing and curvy sizing for this pattern. So it's really a nice big bundle, and I wanted to share a sew along with you. It has options for inseam pockets as well, and a couple of different hem options, one of which is bias binding, which I am particularly fond of because you get a nice peek at some creative bias binding, especially if you make your own. So let's get into that tutorial. So step one is the pockets. So we're going to take our pocket pieces and we are going to serge around each of them individually. And then we are going to place them on our skirt. So if you're using the pattern, you can use the pattern notches or you can mark it about 2 inches down. And that really depends on the size. Obviously it won't be 2 inches if you're doing it on a child's pattern, but on a lady's, it's about 2 inches from that waistline. And then you're just going to pin it in place, right sides together, ensuring that that pocket bag is facing downwards. And you're going to do that for the front piece, which I'm doing here. And then you're going to repeat that onto the back pieces. And you're going to stitch that with the seam allowance that is included on the pattern, which happens to be that 1.5 centimeters. And so here I am just doing the front or the back panel here. And you can see that you want to match it up exactly. So I didn't transfer the markings because I'm just lining up my pattern pieces. But if you want to be precise, you can notch in those notches to match them up. And once it is all stitched, you're going to serge the entire seam as well as the two back seams where the zipper is going to go. And once you have that done, you're going to take your two back pieces and you're going to press that pocket and you're going to push that seam towards the pocket bag. And you're going to do the same on the front pieces. And then the next step is you are going to top stitch on the pocket bag there. Now we are going to stitch the side seams together, which is step two. So we're going to place the front and the back of the skirt right sides together, and we're going to match up those pocket pieces. And when you do that, you really want to pay careful attention to where that seam is, and you are just going to match that up, and then you're going to place a pin. I like to match up the top and the bottom of the pocket bag first, and then I'll go in and I will pin the rest of the skirt starting at the top and the bottom, and then I fill in around that pocket bag. Now if you're not making the optional pocket bags, that is quite okay. Your step is much faster. You just pin from top to bottom and you're going to stitch that in using your 1.5 centimeter seam allowance. Then we're going to stitch and make sure you pivot at that pocket line. And when it's done, it will look like this. So then we're going to clip in at the pocket just on an angle up to the stitching line. Do not go through that stitching line. And the reason we're doing this is so that we are able to press those seams open. So we are going to pop it over to our pressing station. We're going to press the pockets towards the center front of our skirt. And then we are going to take an iron with a wee bit of steam and we are going to press that seam open while at the same time pressing that pocket bag towards the front of the skirt so it lies properly. And your pockets should be rather invisible on your skirt here and you can see where the pocket goes in. Step three, the waistband. So you have two pieces of your waistband, an outer and an inner, and you're going to interface the outer waistband. Next, you're going to fold your outer waistband in half to mark where your center point is on that waistband. I like to mark the top and the bottom because when we place the inner waistband together, we need to know where that center point is as well. Now you can mark the center point using your pattern, but I cut mine on the fold and I still have the fold line pressed into my fabric. So I'm using that fold line as a guide for the center of my skirt. So once we've pinned the center in, we're going to pin either end of the waistband. And then once you have that in place, you can then go in and pin the rest of the skirt to the waistband. Now, because this curve is cut on the bias, it actually stretches and it should lie completely flat. And so the next step that we're going to do is we are going to clip these curves. So I'm clipping out notches to create greater ease of movement, but you could also just clip them with single snips. Once that is done, we are going to press the seam up into that waistband. So you're going to press it up to the top of your skirt, working from the inside of your skirt. And it should look like this. And now onto the optional lined version. So you're going to create the skirt in your lining, putting the front pieces right side together with the back, noting that the skirt will be shorter than the overall rest of the skirt. Next up, you're going to attach that inner waistband piece right sides together to your lining piece, in essence, creating two versions of the skirt. So once you have that stitched, you're going to notch it just as we did with the regular skirt waistband. And then if you want, you can look to add on your optional custom logo tags on the inside of your skirt piece at this point. And now on to step four, the zip. And so what we're going to do is we're going to work with an invisible zipper. And you are going to place your invisible zipper right sides together on your skirt. But first, we need to figure out where we're going to be placing the zipper. So we're going to mark out our 5/8 of an inch or 1.5 centimeters seam allowance going down all the edge of the zipper, because the width of zipper tape is different just depending on each of the different zippers that you have. Next, I have marked the seam allowance along the top on that 1.5 centimeters, so I know where to put the end of my zipper. And mine just happens to fit going along the zipper tape along the edge of my fabric, but every zipper is different, so do measure that out. Stitch that on with an invisible zipper foot, slide it back up, because we need to mark right here where the waistband is and where the end of that stitching is on the other side of the zipper tape. Once we've transferred that marking over, I like to fold my fabric right sides together and just pinch where that zipper is and then undo my zipper. The reason I do this is to prevent your zipper from twisting when you're placing it in, because goodness knows how many times I have stitched in a zipper without doing this and went to zip it up and realized I had twisted it in the process. So double check your seam allowance just to make sure that it is at the correct length and match up that notch you drew where the waistband seam comes exactly to that line. This way it'll line up perfectly. Once it is all stitched together, it should look like this with a seamless area on the waistband. Then flip it to the wrong side with right sides together, and we're going to pin starting at the bottom of your circle skirt. And you are going to pin going up to where the zipper is. And you're going to start stitching at the bottom, going up to the top, and you're going to stop about an inch away from where the zipper is. Then you're going to switch your foot. So first, we're just using our regular seam allowance with a regular foot, stitching up to where the zipper is, leaving about half an inch to an inch away from that zipper. Next, I am switching to a regular zipper foot. Now I'm placing this zipper foot on my left side so that I can get close on the right side of my skirt. I'm going to place my foot down and put my needle in right along the same stitching line. Don't forget to backstitch. And then I'm just pulling my zipper away from the fabric, and I am going to stitch parallel to that zipper, just going past where that end of the zipper stitching goes, as close as I can get to that invisible zipper. This will give you a very seamless look on your invisible zipper. And once we have that here, then we're going to fold it out, and then we're going to press that seam open. And from the right side, this is what it looks like, and it just looks like a seam, completely invisible. Step 5, the waistband lining in the unlined versions. So this is where you would add your tag, and then we're going to create a memory hem. And what a memory hem is we are just going to fold under the seam allowance, which is the 5/8 of an inch or 1.5 centimeters into that waistband. And then we are going to mark the center point. And you'll recall that we marked the center point earlier on in this video on the front waistband. And then we're going to pin the center, and then we're going to pin it going up to the sides, and then we're going to stitch along here. Now you'll notice in this one, I actually folded over the edges, and I'm going to stitch it that way because I'm hand stitching this completely. If you want a machine stitch, you don't need to do that. You just need to pivot on the end and stitch it down, and all you'll have to do is hem the bottom. So next, I am going to press the seam allowance so that it comes up. So our seam allowance is going up into the waistband, and then we're pressing it over, and we have just a slight amount of the waistband from the front or exterior waistband showing on the inside. Especially if you have a contrasting waistband, you want to make sure that you roll that just slightly. And then next, we are going to stitch this. You can do this by machine, or in my case, I am stitching this all by hand, and I'm using a ladder stitch. If you are interested in learning how to do a ladder stitch in more detail, I will leave a link to how to do that down below. And then you just continue to finish that. Now onto step 5, the waistband lining for the lined versions. So for the lined versions, you attach the top just as you did how we did it before, but what we're going to do is we need to create a pocket for the lining to come down. So I am just measuring slightly under where my zipper ends, and then I am going to match up with right sides together the lining piece, and we're going to stitch that with our seam allowance going up to that mark. Next, working on the wrong side of our lining, we're just going to press that seam open, and then we are going to continue to press the side pieces open. And then the next step after that would be to head on over and press this down so that everything fits nicely. So you can see I'm pressing it from the right side, and I'm just slightly rolling it towards the inside of the skirt. Once we have it all pressed, we're going to hand stitch it just the way we did, except we're going to go down along the side of the zipper. Step 6, the hem. With a circle skirt, you have to let your hem hang for at least 24 hours. Now, if you do not have a dress form to allow you to do this, a good hack is to pin it up with clothespins and a hanger and hang it on a doorknob. This will allow your skirt to stretch, and you can trim as necessary. Here's the bias binding hem, which happens to be my personal favorite. You're going to take your bias tape, you're going to unfold it, and then you're going to fold in one corner because you want that corner to be finished. Just make sure that your back seam is pressed open here. And then you're just going to continue to pin this bias binding on, and you want to make sure that it overlaps just slightly along the edge. And once that is all pinned, then we are going to stitch this in place. So you can see I've stitched it right in where that fold is. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to place it together, and then we are just going to press the hem up. And you want to make sure when you're pressing that hem up that you are pressing a wee bit of the exterior of the skirt along here so that that contrasting bias binding doesn't show. So you can see I've got a little bit of that purple showing right there, and then I'm just going to stitch along the edge to finish that up, and this is what it will look like. And your skirt is all complete. Now that being said, if you're going to do a regular hem, that is quite easily done as well on a circle skirt. I've just serged the edges, and then I've folded it over and pressed it and then stitched it in place. You're going to do a narrow hem on this because circle skirts don't do well with wide hems. Now for the reveal. And there you have it. We are all done our circle skirt. This is such a versatile basic sloper to have in your arsenal because it can really change up a lot of things. You can take your favorite bodice from one of the dresses that you have and mash it up with this skirt bottom to create a whole new look. You can also shorten the hem or lengthen the hem to really vary how this skirt looks on you. I would love to see your makes, so if you do make it, make sure you tag me at SheerStitchery and use the hashtag AvaCircleSkirt. Now, if you're watching this on the first week of launch, I do have a coupon for you to save 15% for the first 2 weeks after we launch the pattern, and the coupon code is SSAVA15. So that's SSAVA15. And that'll save you 15% out at checkout. So if you enjoyed this, do give it a big thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber already, I would love to have you join the family. So smash that subscribe button down below and catch all of the new videos. Until next time, makers, let's get our sewspiration on.